In this lesson, we'll look at how we relate temperature to average kinetic energy of a substance, both with regards to the mass and the velocity. And then we will also look at how we describe the behavior of an ideal gas. And the big thing we need to remember about the ideal gas is that we're assuming things like the volume is negligible, that they're not interacting. And because of that, we can make these assumptions and these predictions. And so we will only be looking at ideal gases. And so what we need to think about is what conditions are most favorable to ideal gas behavior. So in this graph, what we're looking at is looking at one substance. We're looking at nitrogen here, N2, and we're looking at it at different temperatures. And what we want to see is that where the average temperature is. So considering the peak of these curves, so the lower the temperature, the lower the average speed. So that's what we're representing here on the x-axis. And don't really worry about what's on the y-axis. It's just kind of our way of measuring the distribution. It's basically the number of molecules at that speed. But what we're worried about is more the x-axis. So when I look at my sample at 0 degrees Celsius, I see I have an average temperature here. I increase to 100, I see a shift to the right. And when I shift to 1,000, I see a much larger shift in the speed of that molecule. Now, one thing to note here is that even when we are at 1,000 degrees Celsius and our average temperature is much higher than at 0 or 100, we still see molecules going at very slow speeds, because the key here is that we are looking at the average speed or the average kinetic energy of these molecules. So we will still see a distribution. Notice as the temperature increases, that distribution gets broader and shifts to the right. So the higher the temperature, the higher the average kinetic energy, and the higher the speed of the molecule. So based on what we just looked at, which statement is true for a sample of oxygen gas at 500 degrees Celsius? So what we saw is that anytime we have any gas sample, we're always going to see a distribution of speeds. The shape and the position of that peak will change depending on the temperature, but there will always be a distribution. So all of the molecules are moving at the same speed. And so that cannot be true, because there's actually a distribution of speeds. So all of the molecules have the same energy. That statement is also false, because they all have the same mass, and if they have different speeds, then they must have different energies. Third, some molecules are moving slower than others, okay? And that is true. It's because what we're looking at is always the average kinetic energy or the average speed. And molecules at 750 degrees Celsius are all moving faster than the molecules at 500 degrees Celsius. And that is false, because while some molecules are moving faster, the key here is the all, that there's still going to be a distribution. And so if we had a peak here, this was representing 500 degrees Celsius. If we had a curve for 750, we would see it would shift to the right, and the peak would be more to the peak is going to shift to the right, and the peak gets broader, but we still see that some molecules are moving at very slow speeds. Here we look at the other aspect of that kinetic energy equation, which includes mass and velocity or speed. And again, what we're looking at on the x-axis is the speed of molecules. And we're looking at three examples here. We're looking at our nitrogen, helium, and hydrogen. Notice that these are all at the same temperature. If we start mixing identity of substance and temperature, then we can't predict any trends. So what we notice here is that nitrogen, which has the biggest mass, is actually the slowest average speed. And we look at hydrogen, which is the smallest, it has the fastest average speed. Now notice again, we are talking about average speeds. Just like with the changes in temperature, we see distributions over a range. So what we get from this is that smaller molecules move faster on average. Just like with the distribution of temperatures, we still see molecules, even the smallest molecules, moving very slowly and some moving faster, but we're worried about the average speed. So all of these are looking at gases behaving under ideal conditions. So molecules are not interacting with one another, and we get these nice distributions. Many molecules, even real molecules, will behave under this ideal behavior. So when we have molecules that are behaving ideally, we see that they're moving fast and they're far apart from one another. So they're at low pressure. If we start to have molecules that are moving on average much, much slower, or that the pressure is very high, so the molecules are much closer together, then we no longer see the ideal distributions like we see here. Things start to change.